I study in Salesia. It's a good Catholic school.
Oh.
Yeah. I went there. I went from elementary one to form five. It's called form five. I think it's still called form five.
Form five.
In Hong Kong. Now you study till form six, then you enter university.
Oh.
Only 4 or 5 years ago, you study till form five, then you take a gao ka. In Hong Kong, we call it wei hao, hui ka. And then you study 2 years, advanced level. This is the British system. So not everybody goes to advanced level. So, you know, at the wei hao, a lot of people then drop out and they go to find a job. Some people go to study the A-level, Form 6 and Form 7. Then after Form 7, you take another exam to go into university. That was. Anyway, after Form 5, not every high school has a Form 6 and Form 7. Not every student go, right? So so my high school solution did not have a Form 6, Form 7 until my year. And they just decided to open Form 6, Form 7. So I just end up, you know, studying there. Right? So I was good enough student. They want me to stay, and it's close to home. But I had a classmate from Salesia who applied to Queen's College, Wong Yang. You know, it was one of the better high schools in Hong Kong. Still one of the better. And he and I said, you know, hey, why don't we go there and try to apply? He lived in North Point, Bak Kok. To close it all, and, you know, I have no intention. I just want to stay in Tsao Keh Wan, you know. I said, I go with you, right? And my Wei Hao, the grade, well, okay, but not really super, okay. And so as a result, I could not get the application form to the Queen's.
Oh.
They are so selective because they have their own student coming up Form One to Form Five, and they two-thirds of the class is dead. And they open one-third for outside people, so it was very few. Each class maybe had, I have a class of 30-some people, less than 10 from outside. So it was very selective. So I said, okay, I continue in Salesia. So after school started, this friend called me up after 2 weeks I was in Salesia. He said, hey, Sanfanzheng, you know, there's an empty seat in my classroom. He said, there's an empty seat. Maybe someone immigrated to somewhere or someone transferred to another school. I said, you should try, you know. I said, you know, they didn't even give me the application form. Why should I try?
Yeah.
You see, I don't want to be humiliated again, right? But my mother told me, I said, what you got to lose? Just take a half day off and go. But you know, I was going to school, I have to take a half day off. So I make an appointment to see the vice principal. And he admitted me on the spot. Okay, and I always tell the story because he, in his mind, he had admitted me before I went. You know, when I made the appointment, right, he already knew he was going to admit me. See, because I'm in a similar position now, like him, that I kind of know how he thinks, right? Because it's 2 weeks after class, there's a space, he knows my grades. I probably was good enough. I just, you know, I couldn't get in the first round, basically, right? So, and he knew I was motivated and determined, right? I wanted to be there, otherwise I won't take half day off. So, it's just very natural. So I always say, you know, you gotta get, when the opportunity comes, you gotta take it. You gotta give it a try. Basically, everybody wants to go to Hong Kong. So naturally, you know, we all want to do that. But at the time, I read about this physicist at Caltech, you know, in the U.S. There was a magazine, and we read about two physicists won the Nobel Prize in the mid-60s. And I really love physics. You know, I thought that's a secret to the universe. So I said, where's this place? You know, we don't know what it is. California Institute of Technology. We didn't know it was called Caltech. Just say CIT, okay? So, I give it a try, why not, you know? If I can get there, I go, otherwise I stay in Hong Kong.
Very simple. I only applied to one school. I did not apply to any other school.
Okay. And they gave me an exam in Hong Kong because, okay, I got it. So that was in, you know, we took the SAT, you know, SAT. In December, and they admitted me in January. We had to accept in March, okay? And even in March, we have not heard, we have not taken the exam to go to Hong Kong College. The same thing here. The exam in Hong Kong is in late May or early June, yeah. So what am I gonna do? You know, the school is in the US, is waiting, so I said, okay, I said, I'll go. You know, and then I took the exam. Yeah, so, and I did very well in the exam, I remember. I did well in this exam. So Hong Kong U, you know, so I had to apply, right? But my mind was already in California, okay? Because, you know, this is like several months already. So I said, what would make me stay in Hong Kong? If I want to study physics, for sure I'll go, right? Because this is the best place, okay? So I said, what is something that I may do, but I would not do otherwise? So I said, okay, I applied to the medical school in Hong Kong. I did not study any biology. I wasn't so serious about it. Okay, I thought, I do that, they turn me down, I can tell my parents, I go overseas. That was what I was thinking. But Hong Kong U actually admitted me. So I remember very well. Remember, we had no telephone. Basically, there's one telephone in the company office. And Hong Kong U called that phone number. And you know, they did not send, because we're the exception. Right? It's not the normal. We don't qualify, okay? So they call, and I think it was very quick at that point. In my mind, frankly, I don't think I'm a good doctor. My interest is not there, and my mind was already, you know, studying physics in Caltech. And frankly, to me, and just my mind, and I don't think I have the talent. You know, in the high school, when I did the biology class, I don't think I was, you know, I was afraid of cutting up the frog and, you know, all that. I don't think so. So it was very easy for me. But the remarkable thing was my parents did not give me any pressure. My parents. I don't remember what happened. I just don't remember. I remember they didn't give me any pressure. And I know that they really, especially my mother, did not want me to leave. Not because the school is not good, because he just wanted his, you know, I'm the oldest son. He doesn't want to stay in Hong Kong. You know, she doesn't know what U.S. is like. She thinks if I go there, you know, I would be lost forever. You know what I mean? I would never come back to Hong Kong. You know, in those days, you don't have internet. But she sort of kept it to herself. Okay, later on, I found out. So that's how I end up going to study in the U.S. In those days, the first time I got on a plane, you have no internet, right? No travel like the way we do. So the whole thing was a big adventure, a big risk. But I was so excited.